This is the video lesson for kinematic equations. The learning target for this lesson is, I am learning to calculate distance, time, final velocity, and acceleration using the kinematic equations. The success criteria for this lesson are, I can calculate distance using the kinematic equations, I can calculate time using the kinematic equations, I can calculate final velocity using the kinematic equations, and I can calculate acceleration using the kinematic equations. So there are four kinematic equations, what we call so-called kinematic equations. The first one, equation of motion in 1D, we're familiar with this one. So we have x is equal to x naught plus velocity times time. So we've been using this one in class quite a bit. The next one, so this is when we want to know the distance when we're undergoing constant acceleration. So we start with x, that equals x naught, plus velocity naught. So this is initial velocity. So here we have initial velocity times time times one, plus 1/2 times the acceleration. So we have acceleration here times time squared. So x equals x naught plus velocity naught times time plus 1/2 times acceleration times time squared. So we can use this when we have, when we're given a distance, we're given an initial velocity and a time, and we're given an acceleration. Or when we're given distance travel, the displacement, and we're given a velocity and we want to know the acceleration. The next kinematic equation is velocity when undergoing constant acceleration. So here we have velocity naught. So again, this is initial velocity. We have acceleration times time. So if we have initial velocity and an object's acceleration and how long it's accelerated for, that'll give us its final velocity. And then finally, we have the final velocity squared when undergoing constant acceleration. So this is a long one. So we have velocity squared is equal to our initial velocity squared plus 2 times the acceleration times our displacement. So we can use all of these equations given different bits of information that we are given to figure out different other bits of information. So if we're given velocity and acceleration and time, then we can figure out our initial velocity. If we're given displacement and acceleration, we can figure out velocity, etc. All right, so we're just going to work out some problems here and figure out which of our equations we need to use. So Samuel Beck is approaching a stoplight moving with a velocity of plus 30.0 meters per second. The light turns yellow and Samuel applies the brakes and skids to a stop. If Samuel's acceleration is minus 8 meters per second squared, then determine the displacement of the car during the skidding process. Okay, so let's draw a little diagram here. So we've got our car. It's a terrible drawing of a car, sorry. And it is driving at 30 meters per second. It's a positive 30 meters per second. And it's going to this position. Which is some distance, some displacement. And it's accelerating in a negative 8.0 meters per second squared. So the acceleration is causing the car to slow down at 8 meters per second squared. So every second, the car is slowing down by 8 meters per second. So we're going to use our formula here. V squared equals V naught squared plus 2a times displacement, x minus x naught. So we want to know our x minus x naught. So we've got an initial velocity. So let's just start figuring out what we have. Initial velocity is 30 meters per second. Our final velocity is going to be 0 meters per second. Our acceleration is minus 8 meters per second squared. All right, so we can plug all this into our equation here. So we have 0 meters per second squared is equal to 30 meters per second squared plus 2 times negative 8.0 meters per second squared times, we'll just call this x for displacement. All right, so this is 0 equals 900 meters squared per second squared, and then this is minus 16 meters per second squared times x. So we're going to move this over to the other side. So we have 16.0 meters per second squared times x equals 900 meters squared per second squared. All right, now next we're going to divide by 16 meters per second squared. So when we divide by meters per second squared, we're just going to have one set of meters left. So x is going to equal 56.3 meters. So the displacement, so if we start at 30 meters per second and we slow down at negative 8 meters per second squared, so every second we're slowing down 8 meters per second, it's going to take us 56 meters to reach a stopping point of 0 meters per second. Okay, example number 2. A cart rolling down an incline for 5 seconds has an acceleration of 4 meters per second squared. If the cart has a beginning speed of 2 meters per second, we want to know what is its final speed. So we're going to use this kinematic equation. So let's write down what we have here. So we have our time is equal to 5 seconds. We have an acceleration of 4.0 meters per second squared. This is a positive acceleration. We have a beginning speed, so V naught is equal to 2.0 meters per second. And we want to know what is V. Okay, so let's plug this into our equation here. So V is equal to V naught, which is 2.0 meters per second, plus we have our velocity here, or our acceleration rather, 4 meters per second squared, and then our time, so that's 5.0 seconds. So we have 2.0 meters per second plus 20.0 meters per second. Notice that we have per second squared on the bottom of this fraction, and we have seconds here. So our second squared cancels, and we're just left with meters per second. So our velocity then, our final velocity equals 22.0 meters per second. All right, example number 3. A car starts from rest and accelerates uniformly over a time of 5.21 seconds for a distance of 110 meters. We want to know the acceleration of the car. Okay, so we're going to use this kinematic equation here. So a note about figuring out which kinematic equation you're going to use. So you just want to look over the problem, see what information you have, what information you're looking for, and then figure out which kinematic equation you can use. So in this question, we have time, we have distance or displacement, and then we don't have a velocity, but we have an initial velocity, which is 0. So given the information we have, this is the best of the kinematic equations to use. So let's write down all the information we have and we can start plugging it into our equation. So we have our distance equals 110 meters. So we're going to write this as x minus x naught. We have v naught equals zero. And so v naught times t is going to equal zero, because zero times any number is zero. So if we rewrite our equation here, so we have x minus x naught equals v naught times t plus 1/2 acceleration times time squared. So this becomes zero. This we know is 110 meters. So we're looking for acceleration. We have time. So when I was writing down stuff, we have time equals 5.21 seconds. Okay, so let's rewrite all this. So we have 110 meters is equal to 1/2 a times 5.21 seconds squared. Okay, so doing a little bit of algebra, we're going to multiply by 2 to get that half out of the way. So we have 220 meters is equal to a times 5.21 seconds squared. Okay, so now we just need to square this number and divide both sides by that, and that's going to give us our acceleration. So our acceleration then is equal to 220 meters divided by 5.21 seconds squared. So then A is equal to 8.1 meters per second squared, which is the correct units for acceleration. So you see here we have meters, and on the bottom we have seconds squared. So that gives us the correct units for acceleration. All right, everybody, go out there and keep asking questions. It's how you learn new things.